I don't give a fuck. Bitch, I got my mind made up. Doing me, fuck a slut. Bitch mad till that bitch beat me up.
So now that I've lived during a plague, I have a better understanding why most Renaissance paintings are of chubby women laying around without a bra.
Eyes brown like the mighty brown bear. Playful, ferocious, and a deadly predator.
Do you want to go in there?
Just as I fought, you are ashamed of me.
I'm not ashamed of you. I'm proud of you.
Open up.
I just don't want anybody to see you.
I want to know, if I showed up to our date wearing this, what would you do?
For one, me, you, never happening. I'm way too out of your league.
Let's get it poppin' with all my ladies. Hold on. Bitch, did you hear what the fuck I said? Shake some ass!
Where did he be at when they said they doing all this and all that? Tired of beefing you balls, you can't even pay me enough to react.
Because if you're thin enough, then you don't have that ass that everybody wants. But if you have enough weight on you to have an ass, then your stomach isn't flat enough. It's all just fucking impossible.
Let's talk about something real fast. Pimples breaking out like crazy.
This bitch, that's a bloated tummy. These legs
have not been shaved in months.
But you know what? Still a bad fucking bitch, and so are you.
Okay, I wanna show you guys something. So this is a picture I just took like a couple minutes ago. See it? Body, yaddy, yaddy. She flexing hard. And then this is what I look like when I sit down. That's okay, that's fine, I promise. Look, that's what bodies do, you're beautiful.
Hi, I'm Natalie, and yesterday I decided I was gonna go on a journey to become hot. Though I am a plus-sized brown woman with little to no substance, I have come to realize over the years that people of all shapes, sizes, and backgrounds can be super hot, because hot is a state of being, it's a feeling deep inside. So join me in chasing that feeling on my journey to become hot.
I'm tired of people saying, you're big, you should wear clothes like that. You're plus size, you should dress for your size. This is my size. I have a stomach whether I have a baggy sweatshirt on or not. Wear what you want to wear. Am I hurting you? Is my stomach hurting you? Because I'm going to wear crop tops and I'm not going to care. Thank you.
So this is just for anyone who needs to hear this today. Having hip dips is normal. Having a round belly, no, I'm not pregnant, is normal. Having boobs that aren't the perkiest is normal. Having jiggly arms is normal. Having cellulite is normal. Having stretch marks is normal. Having a double chin from your side profile is normal. You know what's also normal is having all of these things and still being considered beautiful. And yeah, no, that's all I have to say about that.
Okay, I can't have preference now? Stretch marks. Okay, 110 pounds. Ladies, if you're over 110, get a diet. Go on a diet.
Okay, there's a lot of things to unpack here. I am a tiny human being. I'm petite, and I'm 122 pounds and 5'4". I'm skinny. I'm tiny. And the fact that you would make anybody feel bad about their body is fucking ridiculous.
But even further, like, weight is distributed on people in different ways. So saying, oh, you should just be 110 pounds means very different things for every single person.
But defining someone's beauty based on how much they weigh is absolutely ridiculous. I don't know, I'm a tiny person, so maybe you'll actually take this seriously instead of brushing off someone who's not my size and weight. I know I have a lot of young followers, so your body is perfect, okay? And don't let any 15-year-old asshole tell you differently.
Don't rush, slow touch, brown on white. I can go crunch, grab and bite. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust, quite wrong. Fizzy pop, where you they go, go, we they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off. Blam the trash, man it's so tough.
Alright yo, put the belly on the body, make a clutch. Seen her watch, now she wanna give crutch. Boy got peas, now she hopping in the pod. Man, a real life sugar gal, I might forget what. When she want dark, told her meet me at the top. Switching lanes the other day, I seen her waiting for a bus. Maybe this a Moncler sweater, diesel denim. Buy another one, my pockets fat like heather. Neck froze like I don't know no better. Benzo truck, white seats and they leather. Go broke never, on my grind. She make it clap like I'm Busta Rhymes. I got the juice, the sauce and all them things. I blammed her twice a night with all my bling. Big Benz, I drive, I brought that thing.
So y'all are gonna look me in the eye and tell me that you can remember the name of every single person you've ever hooked up with?
I swear to God, I thought I was the only person doing these things, and I'm so happy to know that this trend is happening, because let me tell you all. I hope none of them see this, but I have a list. So I kind of have the code name for every single guy, so it's anonymous, and I rate them out of 10 stars of like how the experience was. But I also have a list on my phone, and I do remember their names.
And I also have a Google Doc, and I literally record down every single detail of the experience with every single guy.
And I go into full detail, peoples. Like, this is a 10-page chapter for just one of the guys that I was with. I guess you could read an excerpt of it, just pause it. But I turned my experiences into stories, and so, yeah. There's a lot of stories, some wild shit there. 50 Shades of Grey, what?
All right, everybody's here, everybody's on time. It's gonna be a good meeting. First order of business, we're gonna rename this from Big Bitch Roll Call to Bad Bitch Roll Call, because we're all baddies, no matter what we look like, so. Today we're covering what do you do if you get catcalled. Many viable options. Solid first choice, bark. Bark at them. You could also just say what? Over and over to make them repeat their fuckery, hopefully with less conviction each time, because he'll hear how fucking creepy it sounds when he says it. Maintain direct eye contact and just slowly get in there. Just dig for gold. It'll freak him out. And my personal favorite, because it's only men who catcall, to say, thank you so much, girl. Oh my God, I love your shoes. Because he'll be like, but I'm a big, strong man. And you can say, oh, I'm so sorry. You just have such feminine features. Next week we're covering dick pics.
Roupas que mulheres gordas não podem usar, segundo velho conservador babaca. Começando por clássico que é roupa coladinha. Fica com a barriguinha aqui, fica com a barriguinha aqui. Mas barrigas existem, vocês lidem com isso, tá? Segundo, biquíni. Ah, o que você disse? Vou usar sim, vou usar. Fico linda com esse biquíni. Terceiro, shorts curto e blusinha curtinha. E transparente. Porque fica com muita celulite, não pode usar shorts curto. Amiga celulite tá aí, ela existe, vamos aprender a lidar com ela, tá? Quarto, roupa muito chamativa com muita estampa. Meu amor, muito bonita, né? Vai dizer o quê? Vamos tirar esse pensamento conservador da sua cabecinha, já tá na hora, isso é tão 2010, vamos evoluir. Para com isso. Usa a roupa que tu quiser, a roupa que tu se sentir bem. Tem que parar de se importar tanto com as pessoas.